Importance of Sex Education in Schools in India.
Hello everyone and welcome back to our channel. Today we are going to talk about sex education in Indian school and why it is important for our children to know about it. Why are we so scared of talking about sex? Why is it considered as a taboo? Today's video will try to answer such questions. What is sex education? Sex education is the provision of information about bodily development, sex, sexuality and relationships, along with skills building to help young people communicate about and make informed decisions regarding sex and their sexual health. Sexual health is considered to be a state of physical, emotional, mental and social well-being in relation to sexuality or infirmity, as defined by the WHO. Psychological and sociocultural influences in the delivery of this education can increase the likelihood of effectiveness. India has the largest adolescent population, 243 million, with more than 50% of the adolescents living in the urban area. This figure indicates the importance of specifically addressing the healthcare needs of this considerable demographic, particularly in the developing countries such as India. Any discussion remotely related to sex education is considered as taboo in the Indian society. Does this taboo act as a barrier in the understanding of effective sexual education in Indian teenagers? It is of grave importance that teenage girls and boys comprehend the changes which they go through when they reach the age of adolescence. And this is only possible when proper sex education is imparted in schools. The Government of India initiated Adolescent Education Program AEP in 2007. However, the program was banned in majority of the states due to several protests and moral politics, citing the program's content was inappropriate. Even after receiving negative headlines, AEP was rolled out in selective government schools without proper implementation. Why menstruation should be included in the curriculum in India? The first step is to educate every student with a holistic and engaging curriculum. It should start by creating an understanding of the menstruation process and its role in reproduction. Everyone should be made to understand that menstruation is a normal biological process that brings in both physical and emotional changes. There should be no shame attached to it. Hygiene is an important part of the menstruation, and young girls and women cannot be discriminated on the grounds of menstruation. A core part of this curriculum should also address menstrual disorders, which are one of the most ignored health issues in low-income countries. A study found out that there is a high prevalence of painful cramps, heavy menstrual bleeding and menstrual irregularities among young females. Because of poor understanding of this issue, many don't receive timely diagnosis and relief, which affects working abilities and leads to school dropouts and several reproductive health outcomes, including infection and infertility. Also, including boys in lessons on periods help reduce stigma and taboo around the menstrual cycle. Why a comprehensive program is the need of the hour? Awareness about sex will also create awareness about pregnancies and other related issues, including safe sex and diseases like sexual transmitted disease STD and human aminovirus HIV. According to WHO, the age group of 12 to 19 years counts for some 34% of the HIV-infected persons in the world. Sex education will make the young more responsible and they will take the decision whether to have sex or not, with full knowledge and information. But sadly, the AEP program doesn't include anything about homosexuality. The LGBTQ plus community also faces risk for contracting STDs. Men and women alike are vulnerable to the diseases. According to a survey done by Center for Disease Control and Prevention, Atlanta, USA, LGBTQ plus youth are at greater risk for depression,
suicide, substance use and sexual behaviors that can place them at increased risk for HIV and other sexually transmitted diseases. In 2014, young gay and bisexual people accounted for 8 out of 10 HIV diagnoses among youth. It's been scientifically proven that anal sex is riskier than vaginal sex when it comes to HIV. 18 times riskier to be exact. There are two reasons for this. First, the cells in the buttocks are much more susceptible to HIV than cells in the vagina. Second, both semen and rectal mucosa carry more HIV than vaginal fluid. So if programs like AEP do not include LGBTQ population, it will not only prevent LGBTQ plus students from learning the information and skills they need to stay healthy, but it will contribute to a climate of exclusion in school. While LGBTQ plus students are already frequent targets of bullying and discrimination. That's another reason why we need a comprehensive sexuality education. It would aim to equip children and young people with knowledge, skills, attitude and value that will empower them to realize their health, well-being and dignity, develop respectful social and sexual relationships, consider how their choice affects their own well-being and that of others, and understand and ensure the protection of their rights throughout their lives. Central Board of Secondary Education, CBSE, had issued a curricula in 2005 chalking out a program called the Adolescence Reproductive and Sexual Health Education, ARSH, project. The central government released it in 2006, and since then several states have implemented the program with slight variation according to their own requirements. Lately, the Government of India has brought out the National Education Policy 2016, which acknowledges the importance of sex education in schools. Its proper implementation is still to happen. It is high time that the policy makers realize the inaccurate and wrong knowledge about sex can be hazardous, and it is better for the teenage population of the country to be aware. Recently, actor Sonakshi Sinha spoke about the importance of sex education and said that it's very easy to be misguided by internet and friends. Something which is so natural, normal, which is a fact of life, why is that thing taboo? How can that thing be spoken about in a normal tone? As a parent, we are responsible for teaching our kids not only positive values around sexuality but also the meaning of consent. Kids are never too young to be taught about consequences, to understand the difference between consent and coercion, and to have compassion for others. Consent is the agreement between participants to engage in sexual activity. For example, agreeing to kiss someone doesn't give that person permission to remove your clothes. Having sex with someone in the past doesn't give that person permission to have sex with you again in the future. This is especially significant in the age of Me Too. Kids will be hearing about this movement, and we can use this as an opportunity to educate and identify what consent means. Once children understand consent, they will be better able to protect themselves from unwanted advantages. They will feel more confident about saying no, and they will know how to do so. Kids will be less likely to pressure others to have sex too. And education in consent fosters empathy, compassion and respect for others. All qualities that most parents will agree are desirable. In a country like India, where rates of sexual violence against women are high and prejudiced attitude towards women continues, the implementation of proper and effective sex education is very important. Did your school provide any information regarding sex education? What is your take on this subject? Please comment below.